Good evening. How y'all doing? This is Minister Peyton Moore coming at you. Tuesday night was very disturbing to me as I watched the State of the Union. Some people watched it. A lot of people did. I was one. I watched it when I had time at work. Because it's very important to watch it. A lot of people think it's just a bunch of garbage, but it's not. It's going to show you something if you just pay attention. This is not about being political. This is about humanity and life. The part I'm going to talk about, which is going to be this part three of which I'm going to give you about, is going to be about this abortion matter, this extension of abortion. As you see, New York State passed the law for the abortion extension. The state of Virginia got started, but some other things started to happen amongst the governor, lieutenant governor, and another one of the other Democrats. And Louisiana, I believe they had a hold on it. Either North or South Carolina declined it. They're going to bring it to the review to Texas. And you know California's probably going to jump on the bandwagon and a lot of these other liberal states. The thing that disturbed me the most is when I seen women of all culture, all races, and all white, sitting there on national TV with two pastors sitting in the front and Nancy Pelosi as the House Speaker and Chuck Schumer over there smirking and sniggling in somebody's ear. When the President of the United States, in which I highly respect him for, stated that he is going to do everything in his power basically to protect the children and this ripping children out of the womb of mothers, this abortion deal, as he said, children are made in the image of God and they should not be ripped out of the mother's womb. Unborn children or children that's finna be brought into this world at 9 months. You have politicians telling you that that's okay. No, it's not okay. It's called murder. According to God's word, God bring life into this world and he is the only one that can bring death unless you rush death in your life. It was just sad to see women sit there that have had children to disagree with the President of the United States when it got to that part. And how somber those two pastors that were sitting on the front row, they didn't budge or blink an eye like they supported that. They should have been standing up applauding as Christians, as pastors, as leaders. So this is what I have to say to pastors and leaders right now. If you're supporting the abortion extension law, that a child up to 9 months can be aborted and killed at delivery, you need to get rid of your 501c3 and sell your church right now. Because you are going against everything that God has said in his book about a child. And I mean that. From Nancy Pelosi all the way down to Chuck Schumer to every person that was sitting there dressed in white when the President of the United States stated that a child is made in the image of God, that scriptural that we are, man is made in the image of God. A woman comes from the spiritual rib of a man and that woman is made in the image of God and so is a child made in the image of God. God planted a seed in the man and we produce it into the woman to and conceived it, and she carried it, and she delivers that child. I'm very upset with a lot of my churches that are not standing up. You need to be standing up right now, screaming all the way into Washington, D.C., straight to those people that was dressed in white, and you know who they are. I'm very upset. So I'm going to give you some scriptures, and I'm going to give you some information on this. Now, I think women are the greatest thing that God ever created because women they take on a lot responsibility. And I believe that women should be put in high places and high positions, and because if you can be a mother, you can do anything. If you can carry children, you can do anything. Multitask. So I'm so glad to see a multitude of women of all races and faiths that's holding high positions in Washington, D.C., and judges and congressmen and representatives and senators all over. I'm proud of that. But the greatest gift of all is the gift that God can let you have children. He will bless you with children. That's the greatest gift. Now, society consider women as a minority, no matter if you black, white, Hispanic, Mexican, Puerto Rican, or whatever. Society label you that. I label you as being part of the majority, no matter what color you are, where you come from, or what race that you are. We're going to get into this because this doesn't make sense to me. And you, those people that's voting for this and the people that's going along with this, and that go from pastors to ministers to congregations to senators to judges or whoever. If you're supporting this abortion extension law, your judgment day is coming and God is going to judge you. All right? This book, as I always say, this is a very great book, The Gospel Life. The Gospel for Life, and it's about abortion, wrote by Russell Moore and Andrew T. Walker. I recommend it. I'm going to read some passages out of it. At the biological level, note that God also tells Jeremiah, I form you in the womb. Jeremiah 1:5. This indicates that the development of the child in the womb is the work of God. The work of God, not man. With the Bible's teaching that God upholds the universe by the word of his power, and you find that in Hebrews 1:3, we can also extend what the Lord says in Jeremiah 1:5 to all humans. It didn't say some, to all. God sustains the universe, and he is at work in the development of every child in every womb. If God knows people prior to their being formed in the womb, and if God is the one who forms them in the womb, then surely we are dealing with human beings made in God's image in the womb. So it is not a stretch for us to affirm that the lives of the unborn are equally precious in God's sight. As image bearers, these little ones are endowed with the full measures of dignity afforded to all human beings. What we learn from Jeremiah 1:5 can also be found in Psalm 139. David asserted, For it was you who created my inward parts. You knitted me together in my mother's womb. I praise you because I have been remarkably and wonderfully made. My bones were made not hidden from you when I was made in secret, when I was formed in the depths of the earth. Your eyes saw me when I was formless. All my days were written in your book and planned before a single one of them began. Now, we see a number of truths about the unborn from this passage. Once again, the passage affirms that God has personal knowledge of every individual being prior to their development. We see this from David's assertion in Psalm 139:16, that all his days were written in God's book when none of them had yet to be, when his substance was yet formed. This means that God knew David before he was conceived. Second, what we see again, that God is at his formation of children in the womb. David speaks of God knitting him together in his mother's womb in Psalm 139:13, of himself being made in 139:14, and of God weaving him together in 139:15. Third, David says in 139:15 that his bones and his frame were not hidden from God when he was being made. This means that God was watching over David while he was in the womb of his mother. And further testifies to God's active involvement in creating every human life and indicates that we should, in fact, recognize the personhood of the unborn. This is God's word. This is not my word. No man have no right, or no woman have no right to murder a child. I've been through that. I've experienced that at a young age. Man, don't you know since 1973 that the Roe versus Wade cut you out of the deal of saying anything about the right of a woman having a child? If she lay up there and say she want the baby out, the doctor's going to listen to her. They're not going to listen to you, because in their mind, they feel that they have the right to do whatever they want to with their body. Miss Kamala Harris, I'm sorry, sister. It's your body. You're right. But God created your body, and he created my body as well. And he created everybody's body here. We don't own this body. God owned this body. This is his creation. This is his creation of me and the creation of you as a woman. So God created everything here, male and female. You don't own that. If that's what you believe, that you can make a decision on whatever you want to do with your body, well, you're going to have to deal with the consequences of that. You're just going to have to deal with the consequences, because I'm telling you, it's not right. And those doctors are going to damage you. This is not a form of birth control. Please get into God's word and understand what God is saying. See, what people is looking for in the Bible, they're looking for the word abortion in the Bible. God is speaking on it. He's telling you about it. The word isn't there exactly in the Bible, but God is telling you about it in certain areas of the Bible. Jeremiah and Isaiah, that should be enough for you right there. Genesis should be a whole lot for you right there. So I don't understand what's going on in some people's minds that call yourself a Christian. You're getting up in church, you're getting up in pulpit. To me, I just call it you playing church. You're wearing suits and getting up in the pulpit, preaching, carrying the Bible, and you're wearing these big hats and these flowered hats and these long dresses and your heels and packing your purse and your Bible in your hand and speaking in all these fake tongues and all this fake shouting and dancing that you're doing, but you're going to sit up here and you're going to support abortion? It's no way. It's no way possible that you can sit up here and be supporting abortion and anything else that go against God's word. Because God tell you the practices that he tell you, those things, those sins that you're doing, you will not enter to the kingdom of his heaven. And nobody here is perfect. We all working on perfection. We all are sinners. We all going to miss the mark, but we can work and eliminate a lot of things that we do each and every day. So I just think that was just a disgrace. I think that was just to show you the disrespect and the unloving, unkind heart that those people had sitting there in white, as I call them, looked like they was going to do communion or the usher board. And this woman that's leading the house, the speaker of the house, is evil. Chuck Schumer is evil, and those people have some evil thoughts in their mind. And you all need to open up your minds and open up your ears and open up your hearts and realize what's going on and what's being said and how it's being done. These are the same people that you keep voting for, putting right back in office. And these are the same people that tell you that you can't pray in school. These are the same people that's telling you that you can't use the name Jesus in public. These are the same people that you continue to keep putting back in office. Because of the color of their skin. I don't vote for people because of the color of their skin. I vote for people that have some morals and some moral standards according to God's word. Who said that they was going to be a full Christian? Who said that God put people in positions that is going to be a Christian or whatever. It may not, he just may believe in God, but he may not be able to say a full Christian or whatever. Suppose you did get a pastor that ran for president and won. Don't you know the world would be in a big uproar? Because if this man is a God-fearing man, he's going to go in God's word and he's going to follow the laws of the land and he's going to be direct and he's going to be firm, and a lot of people won't even like that. And it's going to be a lot of so-called Christians wouldn't like it either, because he's going to dig into your world. It's going to be hard enough him digging into the secular world, and he's going to really dig into your world. So I want you all people, let's get off of this Republican Democrat thing and start looking at the humanity of life and start looking at respect and morals. And I mean, these morals are so high and these standards are so high, they have to be according to God's word. Because if they're not according to God's word and you're going on what man's standards are, you're failing. And if you call yourself a Christian and you're going on man's standards, you're really failing. Church, we need to start speaking up. I don't care who, what faith you, I don't care nothing about no Church of God in Christ, Church of God, Methodist, Baptist, Second Baptist, First Baptist. If you call yourself a Christian and you're flaunting around with this Holy Bible and you're preaching from it, you better be real with it. Because to me, what you're doing, you're speaking from your lips and not from your heart. So what I'm just telling you, I hope you all have a nice day. And I'm not here to condemn anybody, but I'm just telling you that was wrong for them to sit there. And if you agree with that, I have a problem with you. Because God created us in his image, and your body is the temple of Christ. Now, if you're going to argue against that, well, that's going to be between you and God. Don't argue with me about that. So I want you all to have a nice, beautiful day and enjoy it. And I hope everything works out for you and you all have peace and joy into your life. May God bless you and thank you.